This video will demonstrate the microsurgical clipping of an ICA terminus aneurysm. The patient is a 68-year-old woman. She had an incidental aneurysm found during workup for sinusitis. She also had a positive family history for aneurysms, including rupture, with high anxiety as a result. She preferred surgical intervention over observation. Here are her images. The MRI on the left shows the aneurysm projecting superiorly at the carotid terminus. The MR angiogram on the right shows this broad-based aneurysm, again at the carotid terminus. The patient was positioned supine. A standard pterional craniotomy flap was used. Key surgical steps included this craniotomy with wide Sylvian fissure split to view the ICA bifurcation from the side. The key steps also included the dissection of the recurrent artery of Hubner off the aneurysm fundus and the medial and lateral lenticular striates behind and adjacent to the aneurysm neck. The clip was applied horizontally with its orientation across the terminus. Finally, checking for perforator patency was critical. Here is an overview of the surgical corridor. The frontal lobe is to your left, the temporal lobe to your right. This is the view down the Sylvian fissure, dissecting these bridging Sylvian veins to preserve them. Here the Sylvian fissure is split further, and you can see the dense adhesions between the frontal and temporal lobe at the anterior aspect of the fissure. The optic nerve is brought into view. The supraclinoid segment of the carotid artery is also brought into view. And now we begin to see the aneurysm base. The M1 segment is followed medially to arrive at the neck of the aneurysm. You can see the preservation of these bridging Sylvian veins. And what we find here is that the recurrent artery of Hubner, which is quite substantial in size, is densely adherent to the fundus of the aneurysm. So this next sequence is the gentle breaking up of these adhesions and the freeing of the recurrent artery off of the aneurysm. This enables a more clean access for the clip to be applied across the neck. Here now we're moving behind the aneurysm to identify these perforators off of the back of the carotid that might be jeopardized by the clip. I'm going to use a temporary clip as I finalize my dissection and place my clip. You can see here that to get into that cleavage plane medially requires some pressure on the aneurysm to open up that cleavage plane. Here now I'm going on with a straight Yostergill clip right across the neck, the blades roughly parallel, the A1-M1 contour, and I've worked the blades around the perforators on the deep side. You can also see how the recurrent artery of Hubner is well above the blades of the clip. The temporary clip can come off, and now I'm inspecting further. You can see these perforators on the lateral side, nicely cleared away. But as I palpate the aneurysm dome, I actually feel some pulsation, which tells me that the tips of that first clip aren't closing completely. The atheroma within the jaws of the blade are keeping the tips from meeting, and so this fenestrated clip goes around the atheroma and applies additional closing force at the distal neck. Here now is just a view more medially to that trunk of perforators on the medial side. Now the aneurysm is soft. This is an icy green confirming patency of that recurrent artery of Hubner, as well as the deep perforators. The patient's posterior communicating artery was infundibular in its shape, but it had a thinned wall with this cherry red color and some bulbousness that was suggestive of a early aneurysm forming there. Therefore, I clipped the aneurysm. This is a straight clip going on the aneurysm, and you can see that the clip slides over the dome and does not get a good purchase. But if we go in with a second clip under the first clip, using the first clip as an anchor or foothold for the second clip, we can then get a deeper application, a better purchase, and that secures that bleb of the posterior communicating artery. Here now is an overview showing the view down the Sylvian fissure with preservation of the veins. The patient did well immediately postoperatively. She had no focal neurological deficits. She was discharged home on postoperative day 3. Here is her CT angiogram showing the clips across her carotid terminus. In conclusion, ICA terminus aneurysms require thorough splitting of the Sylvian fissure to visualize both the M1 on the lateral side and the A1 on the medial side. Perforator visualization and dissection is critical. The clip should be applied in a fashion that is oriented parallel to the A1 and the M1. Inspection is needed post-clip to confirm perforator preservation. The tandem clip technique shown here may be needed to close the distal neck of atherosclerotic aneurysms. Thank you.